What's up, Rad World, and welcome back to another episode of Review. Pete's Dragon, directed by David Lowery, and it's starring Bryce Dallas Howard, Robert Redford, Oakes Fagley, Una Lawrence, Wes Bentley, and Carl Urban. I was extremely skeptical about this at first. I absolutely love the original, and I thought they were going to ruin it. But I need to appreciate the original for what it is and appreciate this remake for what it is. And it is really, really good. Disney is always good. I'm a lover of Disney, and they're really not going to do anything that I don't like, I don't think. But it was very, very well made. The casting was perfect, especially Pete, which is Oakes Fagley. And he is extremely, extremely talented. And I really look forward to more movies that have him in it. And something that's really going to challenge him as an actor, too. Because I feel like this role did. And he played it very well. Also, the other kid in the movie, Una Lawrence, which is also in Bad Moms, she's very good. I feel like it's not a character that challenges her acting skills or anything, but she brought a lot to the movie and was really, really sweet to Pete. They had a good chemistry going on, and she sang this song that made it okay not being a musical. I was really hoping it was going to be a musical because I'm a sucker for musicals, but she sang this little song that's about finding dragons by the North Star, and it was just a very, very nice touch, and she had a very sweet voice. It was really good. Bryce Dallas Howard, which is actually Ron Howard's daughter, she plays Grace, and the one that is very motherly to Pete, and I really like her character because instantly you know that she is very soft-hearted and just good-natured, and I really like that. Robert Redford, he played the dad. I wish that they would have went a little bit more in-depth with his character and had more of a backstory. Because after all, he is the one that has seen this infamous dragon. So I was a little disappointed in that aspect, but it was still really, really good. Then you have the bad guy played by Carl Urban, and you don't absolutely like hate his guts, but you don't think too fondly of him. He works for a lumber company, and he's cutting down more of the forest than what he's allowed to. And then he comes across Elliot, the dragon, and is the one that ends up trying to find him and hunt him down and all of this. So you don't usually see him as a villain. You see him as the smartass, which definitely is a smartass in this one. So he plays the part very well. It seems to be natural for him, which is good. And then there's Elliot, the dragon. When I was seeing the trailers, I really wasn't sure of his look. But once I saw him on the big screen, it was wonderful, and he was just a big, lovable dog and still had that personality that I love from the old one. And he really just was like the comic relief, and he would do something silly, and you'd just hear kid laughter throughout the whole theater, and it was really, really fun. Definitely a movie that you'd want to see with your family. The only bad thing I can say about this movie is I really wish they would have had little Easter eggs throughout it that only the people that seen the original would catch on to. Other than that, really not disappointed with it. It is very well made, very good, and perfect family movie. Pete's Dragon gets a 4.75 out of 5. It is a great family movie. If you have a family night planned, take your kids and go watch Pete's Dragon. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to like and subscribe. And if you're wanting to learn more about the original, check out my episode of Rewatch where I talk about the 1977 Pete's Dragon. Later, Rad World! And it says everything that we're thinking and just don't feel like we can say, so.
I had a lot of fun with this movie. This movie was really, really entertaining. The whole cast seemed to be